Hi everyone, my name is Gavin Stone and I'm a product lead for RMM here at NinjaOne. Today I'll be demonstrating and talking about our software package repository, a feature that will give you much better control of your application installations along with enhanced deployment options so installing your software is easier than ever. First I'm going to start out by showing you where the new automation options and sections are in Ninja. If you come across to Administration and go to Library, you'll see a new option called Automation. All your scripts are still in here, but this is also where all of your install applications will go. If we click on the Add button and go to App Automation Installation, you'll see a new screen that allows you to fill in lots of different bits of detail about this particular install application. I just want to draw your attention to some of them. You can choose between a uploaded file or a URL, and that will take up to 1 gigabyte in size. And when you upload this file, it's also scanned by Ninja in the background to make sure that it doesn't contain anything malicious. One of the other things you can do in here, which is a new functionality, is you can categorize your software installations, and that's what helps you view them in the automation library. A couple of new features that we have in here are helper files. Are files that deliver with the app installation on the endpoint. You can add up to 5 at a maximum of 100 meg each. And you can also customize an installer icon for use within the Ninja library. This doesn't go down to the device itself, but it stays within Ninja to help you and your technicians order and visually see installations. We also have added in the pre and post script options, which allow you to run a script before and after an app installation. So maybe to configure a profile or add a license key or whatever you want to do. So I have one actually that I've generated earlier. I can filter down in here for the install application, and I have an installation for Audacity. If I come into that, you can see one that I've pre-filled in. I've uploaded the Audacity executable. I also have added a parameter, which for a silent installation is /very silent for Audacity. And in the additional settings, you can see I'm delivering a license key text file with this, and I have an installer icon here. So from there, I can come into my organization, go into my device, run an automation install application, choose Audacity, tell it to use the silent installer, and click run. I'll pause for a second and give that an opportunity to do. Okay, so that's completed. You can see the action completed activity on the right hand side, and this outputs technical details about what was done and what executed for the installation. And if we flip to the actual VM that we've been testing this on, you can see the Audacity logo on the desktop there. So back to the web app. Once you've built an installer and you've tested it, you can put it pretty much anywhere in Ninja that you can run an automation, whether that's ad hoc, inside a scheduled script in a policy, inside a scheduled task, or even as an automation on a condition. Hopefully, you can see the benefits the software package repository brings to enhancing your application installations and improving your overall automation in NinjaOne. And I'd like to thank you for watching this demonstration on NinjaOne's software package repository.